got mail.
The Berenstain Bears.
In the Dark.
By Stan and Jan Berenstain.
Hi, I'm Sister Bear. Welcome to Living Books. This is a story about the time Brother Bear read me a scary book and made me afraid of the dark. Does that ever happen to you? If you want the story read to you, click right here. If you want to play inside the story, click right here. Play.
Being afraid of the dark doesn't just happen to you. It happens sometimes to little bears, too. Sister and Brother Bear were at the Bear Country Library. Sister had already chosen her books and was waiting at the checkout desk.
Brother Bear, are you going to take all day to pick your books?
Hold your horses. I'm looking for a good mystery.
In.
I'm checking this in.
Out.
I'm checking this out.
Those were great books. I think I'll get some more.
I feel a song coming on.
Oh, I love books. I read them every day. I check them in, I check them out. I want to know what they're all about. So give me a book to read, 'cause books to read are what I need. I love books.
Thank you.
Yow! Hey, how would you like me pulling on your tail?
Oh, excuse me. Oh, my goodness. I just love thrillers.
It's a book about music.
It's a book about flying. Excuse me, do you have any baby bear books?
There should be one there.
I can't seem to find them.
Cubs Corner.
Hey, quit pushing.
Mysteries. Who done it?
Who's flipping those drawers open? That does it. I'm out of here.
Orange Democide.
Cool! Pirates!
Brother, how hard can it be to pick a book?
I'm going as fast as I can.
Well, hurry up! Haven't you found anything yet?
I'm going to look over here.
Brother Bear.
Sister Bear usually took out storybooks and books about nature, and sometimes books of poems. Brother liked those too. But lately, he'd become interested in mysteries, especially spooky ones.
Hey, this one looks good,
he said finally. Said Sister. It was called The Case of the Crying Cave.
It looks scary to me. Did you know that butterflies start life as caterpillars?
Ugh, boring. I like mysteries because they're scary. The Case of the Crying Cave. I can't wait to read it.
I like my books better.
World music.
Jazz.
Rock and roll.
Folk.
Hey, check me out.
No, check me.
I love a good book. I love a good book.
I find the library very enlightening.
Build your brain. Read.
Let's check out.
Okay, it's about time.
Say, this is really good.
Said Brother later that evening when the Bear family had settled down for some reading.
Would you like me to read it to you?
He asked Sister. Sister was looking at a storybook about three kittens who were arguing about which was the prettiest, and it was a little boring.
Or are you scared?
Of course not.
Papa!
I just love the funnies.
Daisies.
I see the berry harvest should be good this year.
Mmm, berries. My favorite.
Papa, everything's your favorite. Pretty scary, huh?
Oh, you've been practicing again, Mama.
Those were great!
I'm cuter than you are. No, you're not. I'm the cutest.
No, I'm cutest.
Are you going to read it or not? It's pretty scary.
I don't care.
Are you sure you want to hear this?
I told you, yes.
Okay, here we go. The Case of the Crying Cave.
The mystery began quietly. It told about some bear scouts who were on an overnight campout when the scouts discovered a dark, secret cave. Brother's mystery began to get a little exciting.
A mysterious cave, said the Bear Scouts. We should explore it.
And when the cave began to cry and wail, it was anything but quiet.
Ooh, cried the deep, dark, mysterious cave. Ooh!
Stop! That's enough!
Nut? No, after you.
No, I insist.
Oh, why thank you.
Huh. It's dark in here.
This is scary, but I like it.
What? Brother Bear, what are you doing?
Just reading my book, Papa.
And then the little kittens
went into the dark cave.
Brother Bear, stop that!
Sure is noisy around here tonight.
I don't think I like mysteries.
Scaredy bear, scaredy bear.
Stop it! Stop it!
Scaredy bear, scaredy bear.
I'm leaving!
And that's quite enough of that.
At the cubs' bedtime, Papa and Mama said goodnight.
Good night.
Good night, cubs.
Turned off the light and left the cubs in the usual sleepy darkness.
Good night, Mama and Papa.
Good night.
Outside the treehouse, the bright, busy sounds of the day had given way to the soft, soothing sounds of night. the quiet conversation of frogs and toads, the soft cry of the owl, the sigh of the night wind. And if you listened very hard, you could almost hear the softest sound of all, the sound of lightning bugs switching their lights on and off, on and off.
Who's there? Who wants to know? Who else? Who are you talking about? Who cares?
Not again! Every night they do this!
Woo 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 woo! I feel a little dizzy.
Brother Bear, does it seem noisier than usual tonight?
No.
It's about bedtime, dear.
Okay.
Oh, not in the mood for a light lunch, eh?
I'm just a little bit hungry.
Hungry again?
What's that?
I gotta go on a diet.
It was a dark and stormy night when...
Oh, stop that! You know I hate scary stories.
That's right.
You said it.
Hey, if you're scared, hop over to my pad.
I'd rather croak. Say, do you ever get scared out here in the dark?
Never.